Okay.
Hello, it's Jen Compton here from Life's a Mango.
How's it going?
Very well, thank you. And I am here to interview today George Johnston, who is the very proud author of the new book, Into the Storyverse. Yes. Hello, George.
Yes, it's my baby.
And what a beautiful baby.
Yeah.
I did finish this lovely story last night, and I can honestly say it has really touched my heart in so many ways. One of the reasons is because the main character is called Dusty, and Dusty takes us on, well, an external journey to Scotland, but also an incredible internal journey. And I found that after I'd read a bit of what Dusty had been going through, then there would be this beautiful verse, and the verse just seemed to encapsulate the essence of what I just read. And I guess it was because the verse spoke to a different part of my brain, or maybe to my heart, but it just seemed to really drive home what you, the author, wanted to get across to me. So thank you, George. What is the story basically about? Can you just share with us?
The story's about a man called Dusty, as you mentioned earlier, who is dealing with the suicide of his friend, and he feels guilt, and he feels regret, and he has a task to perform for his friends. It's just really the journey he takes, which is a physical journey and, if you like, a spiritual journey as well. So it's got things in there that people may be able to identify with.
Oh, absolutely. I think everyone will identify with this story, especially the way he looks at other human beings. And he seems to really, really sum people up very well, which perhaps is something that you also can
do,
isn't it?
Maybe, yeah.
So, tell me, as I was reading the book, and you have these beautiful pages where, the story part will finish and then the verse will begin. Did you write the verse first or the story first?
The verse came first, and I'm an intuitive writer. I write by intuition, and when I hear a story, I know that it's part of a story, even if it doesn't make total sense at the time. So the verses were like puzzle pieces. That came to me, and I knew there was a picture, but I didn't know the picture until I decided to join it together as one story. And that's what intuition is like when you write that way. Just follow
yeah, I totally that. Get that, because yeah. When I write my poems, I have a really strong essence that I need to put something down on paper, but I can't see the beginning, middle and end of the poem. It just starts to evolve. So I guess I must be an intuitive writer as well.
It kind of means that you have no idea what you're doing. Until you've done it. And then you go, yeah, I've done that. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, and it's kind of listening to the universe, aren't you? You're just sort of you're becoming a bit the medium for the message that needs to be.
It's mindfulness. It's being in the moment. And that is part of the thing.
Oh, absolutely. As I was reading it, I typed out all these quotes from the book that just really spoke to me in a big way. And there was something here that I really, really enjoyed. Yes, here. This was all about, very Life's a Mango saying we're in the moment, like life is all about what's happening now. And this is a quote from the book. Life is not on the horizon. You are already there. Life could be resilient and fragile at the same time. The sharp knife of each moment cuts between past and future. We only have a moment. Another. So very, very wise. So wise. There was a particular poem or verse that I absolutely loved, and I was wondering if you might read it for me. It was on page 49.
I can do that.
Thank you.
All right. And in reading this, the book is to be read as one continuous story verse, which is a blending of story and verse. So I wouldn't normally read something out of context. So. It is in a way out of context, but just letting you know that's why this book is different. It's story-based. So here we go. Conviction before trial. Sounds backwards, but I'm not in court. I mean, life, messy life, where trials come. No one misses that. Trial and error, we all use it. If I have the conviction to hold my moral compass between my head and my heart, then my heart will be hard in my head, and my head will be hard. There is no condemnation. I am convicted before trial, convicted to use faith, which is tried and tested try to be gentle on myself and not live in terror. For life is full of trial and error.
So true. Thank you, George. Now, there was something else that you mentioned God in your book, and we all have a different idea of what God is. Some people think God is the universe, some people think God is love, and we all have a different interpretation of what that is. You tell me you're a bit of an unorthodox Christian. What do you mean by that?
Well, just in the sense that I'm not really interested in getting into nuanced debates about different things that people believe. I mean, there's a place for that, and it's private for me. But if, as is Dusty's case, God is love and love is God, people understand love, and they understand what it does, and to be loving towards someone, that practice is encouraging them through the things that bring them life. And the starting point from this is just helping people identify with the story, stay in their moment, and live their own authentic life, whatever that turns out to mean.
So be authentic.
Yes, authenticity.
And I love how you say, what brings you life, what brings you joy.
Yep.
This is what you want people to get out of your book.
Yes, yes. So it's not about giving answers, it's about giving you new questions that you haven't thought of.
Yeah. So it's taking us along with it, taking us to something more. You also say here, if all the world's a stage and we are all merely actors from Shakespeare, then Dustin's determined not to play any role assigned to him. What do you mean by that?
Well, the role assigned to him is, even if you say that you are a teacher, for example, you choose what a teacher means for you.
Yes.
It's up to you what that means. And as a free agent who chooses, makes their own choices, I sort of would rather people have their own authentic choices and not believe a script that's been given to them. Maybe that you're not good enough, or you know, something, there's some story about themselves they don't believe. This is about uncovering your own story and realizing that you can write it. You don't have to write a book to write your own authentic story.
Yes. So this is interesting, because often today so many people are watching things on Netflix and filling up their day with other people's stories on Facebook or whatever platform it is, and perhaps not giving themselves that time to be writing their own story or creating their own story, because they're just looking at everybody else's story,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
Yeah. What do you hope that people will get out of this?
I hope they'll enjoy the story, obviously. You know, the Storyverse is really about something that's evocative, that takes people on a journey that they're not expecting. We have a tendency in our thinking to decide what something is before it happens. You decide something before it happens. And you might decide, oh, this is a book of poetry, or it's a book of whatever. It is different. And when you get into the story, hopefully people will just enjoy how evocative it is, and how it feels real and authentic, and what they get out of it is really up to them. It's a book for everyone, really, in that sense, which is unusual.
It is, actually, and I was thinking, when I finished the book, I thought, oh, I just know somebody who would absolutely love this book, and so I've already got plans to send it to Andrew Bienkowski, a friend of mine over in America. He's been a psychologist his whole life, and he's also a poet, and I just know that it would really speak to him in a big way. So where can people get this jewel of a book from?
They can get it from my website. My website is not to be confused with... My name is George Johnston. It's not to be confused with the Australian journalist from years ago.
Right.
It's one word, George Johnston author.
.com. Okay.
They can also find it if they put in the title of the book. It's the second way to find it, same thing. Put in the title into the Storyverse and it'll come up with details of my book. And you can order it from there. $19.95. It'll also be available through Ocean Wave Publishing, which would be great.
Who was your mentor?
I had Joshua and Thor. They go by superhero names.
Yes,
Thor.
Yeah. Well, they are Ocean Republishing super team.
Yep.
Really went the extra mile on this book, because it's just fantastic.
Yep.
So congratulations, George. Wish you all the best with this book. And yes, please do yourself a favour and have a read. See you later.
Yeah.